Let me give you a guided tour. Let us learn some more.
Welcome back to my channel, I'm the Amastorian. And this time we're gonna have a look at the Arholma battery. And this one is one of the latest and most advanced weapon systems in the Maritime Strip Line. Why? Because this was the last system in play before it was deconstructed completely. And the defense structure was completely disregarded completely, and they went over from a static defense to a more mobile strike force, so to speak. And that was with the defense decision year 2000. So let's get to this. Arholma battery was constructed and stood finished year 1968. And the base is meant to be concealed. You're not supposed to know that it's there. That is why the main cannon looks like a big boulder, and the main entrance. I stood in front of this entrance for about 5 minutes before I realized there was a goddamn door there. I had no idea that was the place I was supposed to go inside there, inside the mountain there. I thought that was maybe a closet or something, I don't know. I couldn't see it, and I stood in front of it. Now, there was only about room for 20 to 25 men in the barracks. So many of the... And they usually slept in three-floored bunk beds. And it was quite crammed in there. Although most of the supporting troops slept in tents in the woods surrounding the base. When you're entering the base, it has a specific biohazard and gas treatment facility. So you're supposed to be safe inside the base from biological and gas attacks. They had their own workshop and electrical shop, with the blueprints to everything on the base, including the main cannon. So there was a lot of blueprints there, and they are still there. You can still see them all if you want to. Just go there and have a look. In the mess hall, they had 3 sittings of every meal due to lack of space and seating places. There were too many people and too little seats for people to sit on when they were supposed to sit and eat. So they had 3 separate sittings. I'm gonna smack up the recipe here for pea soup. And yeah, that is something that the Swedish army is pretty famous for from this time. Wow, they had a lot of pea soup. Some people hate it after doing military service, some love it, but it's very famous for it. And just because it's a very simple dish to make in great amounts, and it's very nutritious. And it's actually quite good, if you ask me. Just add lots of mustard before eating. Lots of mustard. They had modern and well-made latrines and hygiene facilities. They had their own medical facilities with capacity to operate on up to 2 to 3 patients at the same time. And if push came to shove, they had their own... They could move the furniture in the mess hall and use that as well. They also had their own and power turbines to make their own electricity. They also had very sophisticated computer systems to actually calculate where the target is and if it is a target and so on. Now to the main armament. The main armament of Battery Arholma is a 10.5 centimeter automatic turret cannon model M50. It's made by Bofors and came into service in the 1950s. There are two types of grenades. The 10.5 centimeter blasting grenade M50C or the 10.5 centimeter steel grenade M40-74BFL. Yeah, don't ask me what that's supposed to mean, but basically it's supposed to be one grenade that explodes and one that does not and supposed to penetrate. They had 360 degrees firing field and the rate of fire was 15 or 36 rounds a minute, which is quite impressive for a 10.5 centimeter caliber. Damn, that is a lot of rounds, actually. The velocity was about 850 meters per second, and the maximum range was about 20 kilometers. But the most impressive thing here is actually the accuracy. It's quite impressive accuracy. At the maximum range, they had an accuracy of up to 10 meters. That means they can basically hit anything they want within their range. Because most ships that they would fire on would actually be bigger than 10 meters. So what battleship meant for war is less than 10 meters. Most of them are a lot more. At least when you're trying to invade in a large scale of large invasion. And the entirety of this weapon system and the base was in service up until the year 2000, when the whole thing was dismantled. Although Battery Arholma is nowadays a museum, you can go there yourself and have a look at all of this, and it's open to the public, no matter where you're from. In the old days, if a foreigner stepped ashore on the island, he would face prison. Nowadays, it's okay. You don't face prison. And that will be it for now, I think. Although, wow, one more thing. They actually had the M59 uniform in the beginning. But later, in the 90s, they went over to the M90 uniform. And that will be it for now. Bye-bye. Give me your comments. Like, share, subscribe, like the page, follow, subscribe to the channel, and like the Facebook page. And I will see you later. Bye-bye.
Thanks so much for watching. Like and subscribe.